These are the top 10 most liberal cities in America for 2022. These are places with huge levels of rich cultural diversity, nightlife amenities, as well as high rates of unemployment, expensive real estate, and large amounts of social unrest. No doubt these liberal areas have their pros and they have their cons, and depending on your political affiliation, you're either gonna love these places or hate these places. So what I'm gonna do in this video is use data based on recent voting records to show you what the top 10 liberal cities in America are, how much more liberal they've become over the last 20 years, as well as the pockets within these cities that are actually the most liberal. And this is, of course, hugely important to know entering 2022 if you're someone who's looking to change where you live and better align with political affiliation, or if you're someone who just wants to better understand the voting and demographic trends in this country, you're gonna need to watch this video. So without further ado, let's get into the data. Starting off with our number 10 most liberal city, liberal area in America, we are looking at the beautiful, as you can see here with the beautiful skyline in the background, Denver, Colorado. Denver, a great place for skiing and outdoor life, as well as smoking marijuana, is also a great place to vote Democrat. In the 2020 presidential election, 61% of Denver's metro area population voted for Joe Biden, compared to only 36% for Donald Trump. That plus 25% vote margin for the Democrats was the highest in Denver's history. However, what's very interesting is that this heavy dose of liberalism is a recent phenomenon in Denver. And if we go back to the presidential elections in the early 2000s, it's evident that Denver was kind of a 50-50 metro area, which you can see by the intersection of these blue and red lines. And it was really starting with Barack Obama in 2018 that Denver became liberal. Now, what's interesting about Denver, and you'll see many other metro areas that we're going to look at on this list, is that not all areas of the metro of the city are extremely liberal. There's really heavy pockets of liberalism, and then if you go more to the outskirts, it becomes more conservative. You can see that represented on this map, where we're looking at the voting of every county in the Denver metro area. And what's evident is that the most liberal area is Denver County here in the center, which encompasses downtown Denver and the wealthy surrounding suburbs. Nearly 80% of people in Denver County voted for Biden in 2020, compared to only 16% in Adams County to the northeast, or in Douglas County, more people actually voted for Trump than for Biden. This geographic diversity in political opinion is also evident in our number 9 city on this list, a place that is actually the fastest growing large metro area in America. It's becoming a burgeoning tech hub. It's also known for its nightlife and music. This next city, the 9th most liberal area in America, is Austin, Texas, where in the 2020 election, 63% of the people across the metro voted for Joe Biden, compared to only 37% for Donald Trump. That plus 27% margin was the largest in Austin's history. And once again, like Denver, you can see that 20 years ago, Austin was actually fairly conservative. And in the 2000 election, Austin voted more for Bush than they did for Gore. And so while Austin's always been known as the blueberry and the tomato soup, the one liberal city in the state of Texas, actually 15, 20 years ago, it was a fairly moderate city, and only in recent years has it become very, very liberal. However, like Denver, Austin has a lot of geographic diversity in terms of its political affiliation. Most of the liberalism is concentrated in Travis County, the principal county surrounding Austin. You could see here 72% of people in Travis County voted for Biden in 2020. However, if you're someone who's conservative in Austin, you could go to a place like Bastrop County or Caldwell County to the southeast, where more people actually voted for Trump than Biden. If you guys are enjoying the content in this video and you want to see more of it going forward, just make sure to smash that like button. Hitting the like button is the best way to give this video and this channel support and spread it to more people so I can then produce more of this content into the future. Make sure to smash that like button, everyone. Additionally, Williamson County to the north, which includes towns like Round Rock and Georgetown, was roughly 50-50. And as we get further into this video, you're gonna see that there's two types of liberal cities in America today. There's the recently liberal areas like Denver and Austin, which still have a lot of geographic political diversity. But then there's the cities that have been liberal for a long time that really are just blue across the board. And that's the case for our number 8 most liberal city, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the city of brotherly love, the city of Philly cheesesteaks, is also the city of voting blue. And voting blue consistently, which you can see on this graph, over the last 6 presidential elections, Philadelphia has been very consistent in voting between 60 and 65% for the Democrat presidential candidate, with a roughly plus 30% margin of victory for that Democrat candidate. And on a geographic basis, Philadelphia is solid blue all around, from Philadelphia County down to Camden County in New Jersey and Montgomery County to the northwest. Really the only area that you could go in Philadelphia to find at least some moderate level of political affiliation is Bucks County to the north. Philadelphia's consistency in voting Democrat is probably tied to the fact that it has a very diverse population racially, also a high African-American population, which tends to vote for the Democrat candidate. However, this diverse racial makeup is definitely not shared by the seventh area on this list. This area is actually known for being one of the least racially and culturally diverse places in America. We are talking now about Portland, Oregon, the seventh most liberal metro area in America, which voted at a plus 30% margin for Joe Biden over Donald Trump in the 2020 presidential election. We can see on this map that the heavy concentration of liberalism across Portland comes in Multnomah County, which is the central urban county in Portland. It encompasses downtown Portland, where a massive 80% of people voted for Joe Biden in the 2020 election. And Multnomah County, the center of Portland, is what you see most reported on the news in terms of Portland's social unrest, heavy levels of protesting and rioting. That all occurs in Multnomah County, centered towards downtown Portland. That's where this flag-burning protest from 2017 occurred in Portland after election of Donald Trump. And I want you to pay special attention to the people here protesting and burning the American flag. What you'll notice is that they are all white. That's right, Portland is one of the whitest metro areas in America. Nearly 75% of the population is white, and that makes it very different from a lot of the other cities on this list, which are very ethnically and culturally and racially diverse. Portland is not that way. From my experience visiting there, it's a lot of 25 to 30 year old white college dropouts who go there because it's a great place to protest and feel disenfranchised. Now, we've covered so far four very liberal areas. However, you're gonna wanna stick around because the cities that we're gonna see coming up, particularly the top three, are extremely liberal, like so liberal that they almost put to shame the cities that we've seen so far. You're gonna wanna stick around to the end of the video because the top three, it's gonna blow your mind just how liberal these cities are and how liberal they've become. Moving on to number six, our number six most liberal city in America. This is a place that kind of is similar to Philadelphia in that it's more of an older urban city. It's been around for a long time. It has a racially diverse population, is consistently voting Democrat over the last 20 years. We are talking about Chicago, Illinois. As you can see from this graph, Chicago has been a consistent blue metro area over the last 20 years, although there was a hump in 2008, as we're gonna see with a lot of these cities, when Obama was first elected, that changed the demographic of voting in many places. And you can see Chicago went from being very liberal to extremely liberal after Obama and has stayed there ever since. Cook County, the principal large county surrounding the Chicago urban area, is by far the most liberal area of the metro with a 74% vote percentage for Joe Biden in 2020. You can see that the surrounding suburbs are also very liberal, so there's not really a ton of places for a conservative person to go in Chicago and find like-minded people. However, our next city on this list, entering the top five, actually does provide some interesting diversity of political opinion depending on where you move. This next city, often known as the City of Angels, the center of America's entertainment industry, is the fifth most liberal area in America. We are talking about Los Angeles, California, where in the 2020 presidential election, 66% of the metro voted for Joe Biden compared to only 32% for Donald Trump, a robust 35% margin of victory for the Democrats. But as I mentioned a second ago, that margin is not spread evenly throughout the metro. Let me show you what I'm talking about. What we're looking at here are the two main counties that comprise the LA metro, Los Angeles County and Orange County. And we can see LA County is very, very liberal. A plus 44% margin for the Democrats in 2020 if you are very liberal, if you like progressivism, if you like wokeism, if you like homelessness. LA County is a great place to go. Meanwhile, Orange County to the southeast is much more conservative, or at least more moderate. Biden only won by 9% in Orange County in 2020, which means that you're gonna find much more of a diversity of political opinion in a place like Orange County, which includes cities like Anaheim, Huntington Beach, Newport Beach, and Mission Viejo. Should also be noted that Los Angeles County specifically is one of the only areas in America to have a widespread vaccine mandate right now, which means that if you want to go to bars in LA, restaurants, if you basically want to do anything across LA County, you need to be vaccinated against COVID. Now, the next area on this list, number four, is even more liberal than LA overall and is also solidly liberal across the entire metro area. You're not going to find really any Republican or conservative enclaves. This is a place that in the 2020 presidential election voted 67% for Joe Biden compared to only 31% for Donald Trump, a massive plus 36% margin of victory for Biden. Where are we talking about? That would be Boston, Massachusetts. And we can see from this graph that Boston has been liberal for a long time. This is not a situation like Denver or Austin or even Portland where the liberalism has really ramped up significantly. If we go back 20 years ago to the 2000 election between Bush and Gore, we can see it was a plus 26 margin back then. It's a plus 36 margin today. So Boston is just solidly liberal. It's always going to be a liberal stronghold. Likely to do with the heavy presence of universities and medical establishments, as well as tech industries, which all tend to be more liberal in terms of the people who fulfill those occupations. And you can see, as I said before, that it's just a solid blue blob all around the Boston metro area, from Suffolk County, the mainland county within the Boston metro that voted 81% from Biden, to Middlesex County, to the northwest suburbs, which voted 72%, down to Norfolk County, which voted 67%. Everywhere across Boston, including all of the suburbs, is heavy, heavy blue. But actually, based on my experience of living in Boston for 8 years, I never found the liberalism to be that in your face. It's not a very activist city or a woke city. It seems that people have their political ideas and don't really feel the need to thrust them upon you as much as they do maybe in a place like Austin or Portland, where it's much more in your face about how people feel politically. Now, are you all ready for the top three? The behemoths of progressivism in America are coming up. And like I said before, if you thought the cities we just looked at were liberal, these cities, particularly the top two, are in your face liberal. You're not going to believe the numbers, the voting numbers I'm about to show you. Starting off with another metro area that voted 67% for Joe Biden in 2020. This is a city known for its coffee as well as its tech industry, particularly big companies like Microsoft and Amazon. Where am I talking about? That would be Seattle, Washington, particularly the urban area in King County, which voted 76% for Biden. Just how liberal this whole area is. It's one of the biggest liberal enclaves in America, whereas Snohomish County to the north and Pierce County to the south, they are both liberal, but not nearly as much as King County in the center of Seattle. Now, I want you to get ready for our number two most liberal area in America, but so far we've been dealing with Democrat vote percentages in the 60% range. This number two metro area is the first one where over 70% of all the votes went to Joe Biden in 2020. This is a place that has always been liberal, but has become just increasingly liberal and woke over the last 20 years, particularly in the last couple elections. Where am I talking about? That would be our nation's capital, Washington, D.C., the home of our federal government, as well as surrounding suburban areas in Virginia and Maryland, have become extremely liberal. As you can see on this timeline, back in 2000, D.C. voted at about a plus 20% margin for the Democratic candidate. That shot up to plus 37% with Obama in 2008. Again, another area where Obama kind of just really increased the liberalism for a long time. And that's continued to trend up all the way to a massive plus 46% margin in the 2020 presidential election. Liberalism is spread everywhere across the metro, particularly in the center of Washington, D.C., where, get this, folks, in Washington, D.C. proper, 93% of people voted for Joe Biden in 2020, whereas only 6% of people voted for Donald Trump. 93%, 6%. That's insane. There's actually no county in America that's more liberal than D.C. County. We can see that the liberalism does not stop in D.C. It spreads to Northern Virginia. Arlington and Alexandria County are both 81% vote shares for Biden. Prince George's County to the east was a 90% vote share for Biden. So basically, if you're moving anywhere in the D.C. metro and you're conservative, good luck. But if you thought D.C. was bad or good, depending on what your political affiliation is, if you thought it was bad or good, you're gonna think our number one city, our number one most liberal metro area, it blows DC and every other area on this list just completely out of the water. Our number one area is the capital of liberalism in America. No other area holds a candle to how progressive, woke, and liberal this area of the country is. Where am I talking about? Well, I think many of you might already know the answer. This area is known for being very liberal. It is San Francisco. The San Francisco metro area, with a population of almost 5 million people, voted, get this, 79% for Biden, 19% for Trump. That is a plus 60 margin of victory for the Democratic candidate. No other metro area is even close. Like, if we look at the margins of victory stacked up here for the top 10, we can see that on average it was around plus 30%. But here in San Francisco, it was plus 60. It was almost double the average of the top 10. And what makes San Francisco truly special is just how widespread the liberalism is. Not only is it in San Francisco County, which voted 85% for Biden, it's in Marin County to the north, which voted 83% for Biden, or San Mateo County to the south, which voted 78%, or Alameda County to the east, which includes Oakland, which voted 80%. Contra Costa County would be kind of the conservative enclave, but still voted 71% for Joe Biden. And I personally think a city like San Francisco is probably a little too liberal, right? Like, even if you're a liberal person, you probably look at San Francisco and you're kind of like, I don't know about some of the things that are going on here. It's really a monoculture. And the fact that in a metro area with 5 million people, 80% of them can think and vote one way politically, I don't think is a good thing. Other liberal areas that we covered in this video, like a Denver or an Austin or Portland, at least offer certain enclaves that are conservative, or at least offer some different ways of thinking, or San Francisco and DC appear to just be kind of like an echo chamber where everyone thinks the same way, acts the same way, and really don't like or let other political opinions or beliefs through. So I want to know, what do you all think of this video? What do you think of these cities? Did some of these surprise you in how liberal some of these cities are? Did you think certain ones would be more liberal or more conservative than what the data on voting showed over the last 20 years of presidential elections? Let me know in the comments below. Also, make sure to smash that like button if you appreciated this content so I can produce more of it going forward. And if you really, really enjoy this content, make sure to become a subscriber. I come out with 3 to 4 data-driven videos per week on US demographics, especially related to the real estate and housing market.